Welcome back to intplusone channel. This is Carl, and we're playing, well, this is a let's play of Dark Souls 2. Oh man, hold on. Many apologies there. This is episode 7 of Let's Play Dark Souls 2 here on intplusone channel. I've been actually having a lot of fun with this game, so I hated to take a break from it. But we've done a lot of cool things. What have we done? Well, we took out the last giant, and we took out the pursuer. And I think that the last time that we left off, we were in the Lost Bastille. Now, I'll be honest with you, the Lost Bastille is like a really difficult area. I know that when I played it the first time, I definitely died a lot. There's a couple areas where you can kind of get sucked into a little chokehold where, you know, you can't get any further. What am I trying to say? You're like put into an area where your movement and your ability to back up is so constrained that you have to survive. And, well, let's look at Kalane, right? Kalane here, she is pretty darn squishy. And I mean that in the sense that, you know, if she's gonna get hit, she's gonna take damage. And she's gonna take a good amount of damage. And by a good amount, I really mean a bad amount, because it's not an ideal amount of damage to take. But I digress. We're gonna go ahead and we're gonna travel. You know what though? There is one thing that I did not do the last time that I should have done. So we're gonna go back to the Forest of the Fallen Giants, and we're gonna go back to the Cardinal Tower. And now what am I doing? Well, I'm going to get some items that I basically neglected to get. And those items are very, I think, very valuable. Some equipment that'll help us stay alive longer. Because I'll tell you what, the boss that we're gonna fight for Lost Bastille is a really tough boss. Now, we could do this another direction. There's actually another boss. We could go another way. You know, we could go another way. That could actually be really fun. I guess I see some summon signs. Oh, you know what? No, that's absolutely not what I meant to do either. That's hilarious. I'm so used to, I'm switching games so frequently that we actually have the full-sized soapstone here. So that means that we can actually do some, like, real lengthy co-op with people. Which I really like that. I prefer that, actually. But we're going to go this way. And I can't even remember, actually, I think, what I expect to get out of this. I know that it's some equipment, but I can't remember the nature of that equipment. I'm so glad that we actually have a shield. Ah, look at that. Look at how terrible I play. I'm just really bad at this game, apparently. I don't know what I'm doing. Hey, guys, come this way. Come party. Yeah. All right, so that's okay. I got a life gem out of it, right? That'll make up for, like, the life I lost. Not, but that's okay. You know, now that I think about it, I do want to go a different way. To break from tradition a little bit here, because ultimately, there's a couple of paths we can take. But I know that I actually think that it's a little cooler to go the other way. Because we get to see, you know, Huntsman's Copse and get to see some other unique areas. You know, and the Lost Bastille's okay. I think we're going to go there just far enough, though, to trigger some things, actually. So that's what I'm going to do. All right, so then, of course, this is our battle area. This is where we fought the Pursuer. No, this is not. This is where we would have fought the Pursuer had we not defeated him so mercilessly early on in the game. Although I didn't get the trophy for it because I did that, and that's actually a bummer. So, interestingly, we can drop down here. Okay. Oh, what am I doing that for? You must be a crazy person. Well, because down here are some items that I do, in fact, want. So, come this way. Look at that. A whole Drang Lake set.
Wow.
What does that mean? That's some equipment that we got there, buddy. I really wanted that equipment. It's going to help us stay alive a little bit longer. And no enemy can get to us here, so let's see here. Let's compare it to what we've got. Now, I think it'll actually maybe overburden me a little bit. Yeah, Drang Lake mail. But look at how much of a difference that does make for defense. I mean, I could do it, you know. It doesn't put me that high. But instead, I think I'm just going to kind of, in a flair sense, go ahead and grab the pieces this way. So, oh, I don't actually have a helmet for it. Old knight helm. That's interesting. But then we wouldn't get to see her face. That's a bummer. All right, so Dranglake gauntlets. That's not bad. Look at how much that actually increases our defense. I like that. And then same thing here. Dranglake leggings. Now, it does put me at 53.1%. That is a bit unfortunate. I got a slower roll now. But that's okay. I don't actually... I mean, I use my roll. I certainly use my roll. Oh, hey, I forget that. That's the wrong way. Or at least that is not the way that I wish to go. Hey, how's it going? You want to come and play? Oh, he's backing up. Whoa, he's got a game plan. I like his AI. It doesn't know what to do. It's just gonna... Did you see how much damage I took there, too? I just took it. That was ridiculous. Ooh, a Radiant Life Gem. Well, that was worth it. It's okay, right? I don't care that I just took a butt ton of damage. It's not gonna hurt me. Well, I mean, it'll hurt me, but it won't, like... It's not... Ooh, look at that guy. He thinks he's slick. Look at that guy. What you doing, buddy? Yeah, it's all right. It's all right. Just feel the death. It's a part of this world. And there's some alternative areas too that we need to, Oh man, all right. So you know what? It occurs to me that there are some additional areas to explore. Now it's a little early maybe to explore them, but who gives a care? I don't give a care. I'm gonna go. Now I can't remember though if I do have in fact the key to the area I'm thinking of, like over here. No, no, I don't want to be down there. That is a place of fantastic death for me right now. All right, you know, maybe I should drink my Estus flask. Oh, he's gonna fall in. Okay, so you remember that area where we got the cool fire sword that in fact I'm using right now? Well, it turns out that actually came from an area that's right outside of these things here. So I'm trying to look for the creatures. Yeah. Those are the creatures. And we can go down there. It's just we can't go down there yet. We won't survive the fall. I don't have that, you know, cat ring or whatever I'm supposed to have. Yes! Sweet! This is a secondary area at which we can go. That, you know, is okay. We'll get some items. I like eating items. Don't you like getting items? Oh, so cool. All right, Ring of Restoration. Okay, now I don't remember what that does, but you know what? We got ring slots. Oh, Ring of Blades. Ring of Restoration. That's kind of cool, if it actually does what it says it does. I'm not sure if it does, so let's watch our health bar. Oh, well, you know what? Our health bar, I need to take some damage. Too bad this game makes it really hard to take damage. Ha 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 ha. Well, all right, so that's okay. We're gonna go out to the courtyard. I think actually it doesn't actually do what it says it does. Oh, you know what? We can't go in there. Yep. Produce the symbol of the king. That's a bummer. That's a real bummer, but that's okay. There was another area too that I think I wanted to use that key on. So we're gonna go across the bridge and we're gonna go down the elevator and we're gonna take a left. And we're gonna take a little bit more of a left and we're gonna push the button, do the thing. Look at me. Ah, I'm so stoic looking. Nothing bothers me. I'm Kalane, you just don't mess with me. I'm so pretty, I look like Daenerys Stormborn who has like a crazy tan or something. Okay, so there is like an enemy down here. Yeah, this guy. All right, anyway, we're gonna open the door. Oh, it's locked. Okay, I thought I could open it. I am apparently very wrong. So why did I think I could open it? I know eventually I can open it. I've done it before. Look at all those stalactites and stalagmites. Do you guys remember which one's which? Because I don't. Okay. Rock formation. Da 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 da. Let us go. I like all those little red and green arrows. next to my stamina bar makes me feel like I'm just, like, you know, stronger or something. Although, you know, I kind of wish I could do it without the visual flair of, like, all this stuff up here. Makes it a little less fun to look at my character. I love hiding the UI, too, right? I mean, you don't really need it if you're just kind of exploring, so it lets me just kind of look at the world, which is a very beautiful world. I like it. I love it. I want more of... Ha-ha! That was great. Consequence of the physics engine here. And the fact that, I guess, either I just timed it right or he reloaded onto the last pod he was at. But I am unsure. All right, so we're going to travel. And instead of going to, well, you know, let's go to Majula real fast. Yeah, we're going to go to the Farfire. Because if I can just increase my stat, that'll enable me to wear heavier armor. Which I can't remember if that's endurance or vitality right now. We might be able to push it below 50%. I want the defense. I want to be able to take damage a little bit. Is that a great strategy? Probably not, you know? I mean, if I want to be pure about it, ideally, I would be not able to... Oh, you know what? No. I need to leave. Ideally, I should consider the fact that I don't want to take any damage at all. And in fact, should build my character around that. But see, here's the thing. Mistakes are going to happen. Soul of a Nameless Soldier. Dang, we can't even do it. Okay, that's okay. All right, so I'm just going to cut the crap here, and we're just going to go to Las Basile. Yeah, words just don't describe how much this game taught me. I think about life, and really this series, the Soul series, has just been so... Such a unique series, like such a unique game series. It's almost like the momentum that classic games would have continued to go on had there not been some significant changes in maybe, do I want to say people's tastes? No, not really, because people's tastes didn't really, well, they, okay, let me think here. People's tastes changed, or at least what people thought their tastes changed. So, for instance, you know, games with this level of quote, difficulty, which, again, I don't find it difficult, but just trying to find a way to kind of conceptually explain it, you know, with this level of something that it has, this level of progression and all that, people thought it was like, oh, man, you know, old games are too brutally difficult or whatever, and I don't agree at all. So, what are we going to do? Well, we're going to kind of do this number here. We just got some stuff, whatever, right? You know, I'm back here. I'm going to get this treasure chest. What does this message say? Well, I was trying to read the message. Is there a trap? I can't remember. Nope. Antiquated key and covetous silver serpent ring. Oh,
yes.
All right, that's right. So we totally want that one ring. Let's see, what do I have? Life ring. What does the life ring do? Ring of restoration, chloranthi, blue seal. You know, take the blue seal off because it's not doing anything. Fallen foes yield more souls. How useful is that in the beginning of the game? We can accelerate our growth even more. And there's actually a +1 and +2 version. And I'm just gonna, look at me. I'm a terrible person. I'm breaking doors. Yeah. There we go. Sorry, pups. Oh, 2008.
In 2008, I was working for Blockbuster Video.
Whoop. Ah, yes, that's right, you. Yes, you. The one who's taking the pot shots, a sniper. I can snipe too. Man, I wish I had a 100% damage blocking shield, though, because that would be really useful. All right, so we're going to shimmy, 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 and shake up the ladder. Oh, and I got some sublime bone dust. I forgot to use that, too. That'll actually help with how much heals. Wait. Oh, yeah, okay. So, cool. We did it in a way that's a little non-traditional. But we still cleared it. I'm trying to think if there's any reason to be up over here at all other than just to kill them. I don't think so, though. I don't remember there being any hidden rooms or anything like that. And there are hidden rooms. Oh, so sometimes you actually need the Pharos Lockstone to get to these hidden rooms. Other times you don't. And the Pharos Lockstone just kind of serves as a way to tell you that... Woo! Ha! Hey, how's it going? Woo! Buddy! I'm totally out of stamina. Hey, take this. Now, I don't think you can backstab these guys, unfortunately. And it really is very unfortunate, actually, because they are super strong. Oh, and we're about to come across a character in this room right here. Oh, but there's these, all these boxes in the way. How do I do it? I'm just going to push them and, you know, my momentum and physics engine and stuff. Or we can just... Oh, yeah, I'm an idiot. I forgot about that. That's okay. Press the square button. Right. Okay. We open the door. I don't think there's anything down the side there other than death. Oh, man, you know what I always want to do? Well, I won't do it, though. Try jumping. That's terrible, though. Like, I shouldn't be one of those people. Hello, hello. I like your hat. And if we can see it clearly, that is actually a mask. That is not their face. Because if it was, it wouldn't sound like this.
What is it? I don't know you, and you don't know me. Things are better that way.
Oh, well, all right. I guess I'll just walk out the door.
No, I'm just kidding. Let's go talk to her some more.
You are an odd one.
You have no idea, lady.
Normally, people keep a safe distance when they see this mask. But you... I'm called Lucatil. From the land of Mira to the far east, across the mountains. They say Drang Lake brims with powerful souls. And so I came to claim my share. But what a strange place. Even the rumors did not prepare me. You are an odd one indeed. I've always made a point of avoiding people. While you've made a point of engaging me. I can see that you are mid-journey. If you require assistance, I will help you.
Yes.
I come from Mira, a land of knights. My sword is always ready. Don't hesitate to call upon me. Whatever happens, I won't be missed.
Okay, yeah. Sorry. So something that I always do in games. It's a good habit to be in practice of. Well, until I make a game and I make it actually like something that you get a penalty for. You know, like, oh, stop bothering me. Or like, you know, the original Warcraft, stop touching me. So, that's really cool. Okay. She is going to be one of our summonable buddies. And I'm going to go this way. Oh, you know what? And she has an amazing story that I am not going to spoil. So instead, I'm just going to pick this guy off. Hey, stupid ghost, you're getting in my way. I can't see. Yeah, all right. You know, tummy grumbling. Okay. Now, where is it? Be wary of enemy. Yeah, well, there's dogs. I mean, the dogs aren't too bad. Yeah, they just take two pops. That's funny, though, because, like, in a way, it's sort of like having limited ammo. There might be another one across the way. I don't remember. What I do remember is I want to get rid of these dogs, and I don't want to swing around that barrel. And it's not because I'm worried. Ah. Oh, look at that. I forget all about all the complexities of some of the areas. No! No way! Alright, so if you saw what I just saw... Stop! I can't literally see. Why is my camera doing that? I can't... I'm trying to lock on and... Fudge! It's ridiculous. I would not have been in any danger had the, All right, so there is a barrel that I was trying to avoid getting blown up because now I can't do what I was going to do. So now I got to go back through here because there's this big old crack in the wall. And what do we want? Why do we care? Wow, what is wrong with the camera angles? What is wrong with my lock-on? Oh, I'm an idiot. It's all right. We won't talk about what I did. But you can knock that barrel down into the wall, blow it up, right? So the only thing that stinks, and I mean like really truly stinks about this, is that I, man. All right, so I can't go back, and you don't know why, or you might know why, but if you've never played before, you're not going to know why. So I'm going to bone it. Yep, I'm going to return to the last bonfire. Now, the nice thing about Homeward Bones is that you don't lose any souls, so it's kind of a nice way to just reset. I like to avoid using them, at least not until you get sort of an unlimited item that does sort of the equivalent. So, in this sense, I am perturbed that I had to use one. Well, you know, perturbed is maybe a strong word to use. I am not agreeable with it. I am dissatisfied that this is what I am doing, because now I gotta go through the loading times, and oh yeah, by the way, all the enemies... Actually, no. Well, you know, but I want all my cast back, too. Because, you know, maybe I'll actually do some things. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Okay. Oh, man, you know what, though? No, it's all good. All right. So, we'll take out this guy from a distance, you know, because we can. Kind of hate to do it, because I feel like all he's trying to do is defend himself. And I'm just being mean, like, oh, you know, you ever play those games and you're like, oh, man, those sniper enemies are ridiculous. I bet you he's thinking the same thing. Like, you see the way he's all defensive, he's holding up his arms, or, you know, his scythe here. It's like, oh, man, you know, you don't have to do that. And I'm like, yeah, I know, but I'm a terrible person and I really like to kill people. Now, the good news is we don't have to go to that room to the left. We don't even need to know that it exists. I mean, it, you know, it's open and everything. We know it exists. And I'm going to jump like a madman. And, of course, you'll notice that Lucatiel of Mira is gone. Dang, man. I really liked Lucatiel. Where did she go off to? Maybe she went to Lordran. Maybe she went to Boletarian Palace. Whoa, Boletaria. Hey. You're kind of going fast there for me, my friend. Wow. Oh, I'm loving the fact that I got that serpent ring, too. I mean, I feel like this is just wrong, right? Like, one should never be able to get through a Dark Souls game maybe this easily. I mean, I'd still die. Oh, look at that. You see that? That's funny.
That's funny right there.
You know what? How do I get up there, too? I swear. Oh, I know how to get up there. But the... All right, so let's wait. At least I think I know. Oh, well, all right. All right, I just wanna... I wanna get this pup here. Okay. What? What is that thing hanging there? What am I seeing? Oh, I'm seeing, okay. All right, you, come here. We are not triggering it. Yeah. Ooh, that hurts. That hurts a lot. Now I'm kind of being cheap here, but there's a reason. What's the reason? I don't want to lose out on what I'm trying to accomplish. Man, that looks like it should have hit me like a couple times, actually. I'm not going to lie. I feel like there's some collision hitbox issues there. I'm actually trying to remember how you get to that ladder. Oh, yeah. All right, well, since we're back here...
Might as well get the hidden area items.
I'm, like, being all careful here. But, I don't want to fall. It's not a problem to get back here. But it's, you know, I like to use this word a lot. It is suboptimal. Large Titanite Shard. I think there's actually a third tier up there. I can't... No puedo recordar nada. All right. So cool. We can do this. Now I gotta remember. You push the barrel, but I can't remember if you're supposed to roll into it to push it, or not. I feel like no. As long as I think I just literally push it. Yeah. Check it out. Check out my blog. All right, so what are we doing? Hey, look, it's a bonfire. Bonfire is lit. Now we could, of course, rest at it, but that's dumb because all the enemies are gonna come back. So instead, we're gonna open this, and we're gonna pick up an item. It's a large titanite shard, and we're gonna open this. It's a titanite shard times 5. Man, look at all the cool stuff in this room. It's ridiculous. Iron arrow. This guy, by the way, he's not a bad guy at all. He is basically like our blacksmith from the original Dark Souls. Have you happened to play it? Or had you? If you have happened to play it. But he's on something. Man, he's on a treasure chest. That's crazy, right? Jeez. Well, you know what I need to do then? I need to do something about it. You can't do anything about it. What are you talking about, Carl? That's crazy. Well, you know, what about those torches that I have? If I can remember how to equip them. Torches, items? I can't remember anymore. Torches might be considered items. I don't see it. I have tons of torches. Okay, fine. I think then I have to... No? Oh. I thought. Toggle. Light torch. That's what you have to do. Well, I didn't quite mean to rest here, but that's okay. What are we gonna do? We're gonna set this light here. Needs a little light in this room. Okay. All right. What did that accomplish, Carl?
It's locked.
It is locked, isn't it? Well, there's a lot more light in here now, obviously. That's what it accomplished. Like, that makes a lot of sense, right? I'm going to put it out by, like, throwing flames into my clothing that, you know, is probably very flammable. Talk. Meh.
Oh, why can't they all be this easy? We've got a wild one.
Oops.
Oh, that's it, yes. That's the way. Dear friend,
Ow, my head!
Brightly you burn.
I like how their mouths don't move. They talk. They talk directly into your brain.
I ought to fetch a new ember. Flame. Dear flame. I ought to fetch... Flame.
Oh, that's right. All right. So that's cool. He ought to fetch a new ember. Flame, dear flame. Well, let me go ahead and do this bonfire thing. Right. Because... Hey, he's in a different spot now. Interesting. Because... Da-da-da-da. We have now opened this treasure chest. So how do we do that? Because it wasn't obviously just resting there. No. You have to light the fire. Now he's got fire to work on. Or work by. And they got a Craftsman's Hammer and Twinkling Titanite. Ooh. What is Twinkling Titanite? What is Titanite in general, right? We haven't used it, really, in our play. I am going to summon somebody. We're going to have some fun. Oh. We're going to totally have a blast. Going to have a ball. And so what are we gonna do with our summoned buddy? Well, I'm gonna stand here for a minute because it's probably not fair to make him wonder where the high holy heck I went. And man, I really wish it was kind of a silly idea for me to do that because although I should be okay, what I really need is I need to level up And I'm now limiting myself, actually, to not be able to level up. It's okay. It just means that we have to kill the boss. So, I guess we're gonna do that, and I'm hoping my human player will be okay. Maybe if he's not, if he gets us killed, it's alright. Alright, hold on, let's go ahead and do the bowing thing. Hey, welcome to YouTube. Or whatever other media this is on. I wave to you, you wave back. Oh, I like that. Alright, so cool. I am pumped up. Let's do it. Yoink. Okay. I really want that maneuverability, though. It's going to hurt me a lot in this boss battle that I don't have it. It's a good thing you don't fight multiple bosses at the same time. It'd be ridiculous if you had to. Look, puppy puppy. Oh, yeah, I forgot you can do that. Oh, well, sort of. With certain weapons, this appears to not be one. So each weapon actually has its own moveset, and you know, so far we've just had kind of like what I consider the boring weapons, not any of the really interesting and kind of eccentric, cool weapons. Because I have a specific weapon that I want to use. Oh yeah, no, yeah, we don't want our buddy taking a lot of damage, especially not here. Because, we reach a point of no return. And it's literally right here. Okay, so, you know, he just, what, you know, why is it a point of no return? Well, we fall off that and we can't go back. Oh, man, are you serious? I'm totally serious. So, I want to get rid of all these. I want this room to maneuver. Oh, my God, he just did it. All right, so what you don't know is that there's a bunch of little soldier things here. Wait, what? What? There used to be a ton. Did they patch them out? No way. Oh, no, it's just, no? Did they patch them out? I haven't played this game in like a year, but last time I played, I mean, you walked in here, you had a bad day. You didn't even get to the boss. You walked in here and everybody was like, no, it's the chosen one. The chosen one just needs to die. And you died. And you did so, oh, nice. And you did so begrudgingly, of course, right? You know, like, I don't wanna die. Well, you totally died. All right, so I don't know if you wanna really pull that. I mean, you can. We can open it. Because that is another way into that area. There's two ways. I actually kind of want to go the other way, though. Other way's got stuff. I'm always really enjoying the exploration. I wish I had a Pharaoh's Lockstone. All right, hold on. I want to go this way, though, for reals. Because I would like to get those items on the off chance that I die or whatever. And there might actually be some healing items. Oh, let's break it. Break it. All right, you want to know a place you don't go? Well, yeah, it's not there. We'll go there soon. Well, we will go within its vicinity soon. Yep. So, like, this is a doorway to nowhere. So if you open... Yeah, that's right. I just wanted this item. Soul of a proud knight in a human effigy. What? What's a soul of a proud knight? Well, it is a huge freaking soul. It is so big. Like, how big is it? It is very big. Okay. No. Wait, no. Yeah, I want to be this way. I want to run out of my summon time, too, but he's probably a full-blown phantom, so I'm going to go, yep, we're this way. Uh-huh. Ah-ha-ha, yes. There, who's that? Pilgrim Belclair. Yes, we absolutely want Pilgrim Belclair. He is freaking awesome. He is freaking awesome. Now, this is actually one of the hardest boss fights, I think, in the game. We're gonna do it. We're gonna do the thing. And use like one... Wait. All right. Equipment. I know. Give me a second, man. I have like three... life gems, but I do have 5 radiant life gems. All right, we're gonna watch the intro here. Oh wait, there is no intro. That's right, that's right. Ah, that's right, that's right. Oh man, something's in my eye. Oh crap, in real life, something is in my eye. No, my gosh. All right, please tell me it's dead. Nah, that's all right. All right, now you need to, you see there's 3 life bars here. Whoa, that's gonna hurt. All right, this is potentially bad, but I think we've almost got him dead. All right, good, 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 good. Good. Okay. All right, you see that? This is why there's 3 life bars, because there's this guy, and I'm waiting for him to kind of come up here, because he will. Now, our Pilgrim Belclair is awesome at being a distractor. A distraction, but he's also putting himself in a bad position because I can't support him. There we go. Yep, that little round ledge here that actually helps support my No, Pilgrim Belclair, you can't die. I need an extra target. Well, I don't need it. Yeah, he's been vanquished. Shoot! I do not curse on my channel. I apologize. Maybe I'll have to actually beep that out. That'd be terrible. I've actually not had to do anything like that. I haven't had to resort to that. Now, here's the thing. We might have to make this one-on-one, which is terrible. As long as it's not 2-on-1. He healed. Good, good, good. I feel like I'm a sportscaster now. And he rolls to the left, and he rolls to the right. And he doesn't die. Victory for Dark Souls. All right, you know what? He needs some support. So. All right, no, he doesn't. He's dead. He didn't fail, though. He did not fail. He did not fail me. Yeah, you're gonna jump up here, I know. Okay. 1-on-1 time. Alright. I gotta remember my strategy here. All right. Shoot. That's okay. Now, he might do the stupid spinning thing. I don't know. Shoot. You know what? I can magic him to death. Damn it, darn it. Shoot. When I talk about suboptimal things, this is suboptimal. All right. I've done a lot of spinning around and not doing any damage. All right, good. I wish I had more powerful spells. It's okay. Slow and steady. Slow and steady. Yeah. All right. That's okay. Now, luckily, it takes him a while to recover from these attacks. Now, the one thing about Dark Souls Never get too confident. The reason why people die a lot is because they get too confident, right? So, like, at this point... At this point, all I have is a slow healing items. Never get too confident. Never, ever, ever get too confident. And I'm not getting confident, actually. I am terrified. I may lose. It doesn't look like it, but it's riding my nerves. This experience, yeah, really rides my nerves sometimes. It's okay. It's part of the thrill, it's part of the rush. You know, the actual winning, it's difficult. It makes it worth it. Thank you for sticking to your patterns. I know I've just got basically one hit left on him. And he's out. Oh man, he's out. Oh, what is that though? That was a curse count of two. Ooh, I don't like that. I try and keep this channel very PG. You know, but man, did I not mean to curse like that? Well, that's all right. Let's see here. Now this room is full of a ton of hidden stuff. And you would never know that, actually. But there's a lot of cool things in this room. All right, we got a target shield. Okay, so cool. Maybe we get to, like, do some shopping. But that's not the only hidden door. No, my friends. There is another. And, in fact, where does this go? I can never remember where these doors go. I feel really bad about that guy. Man, he really held his own. I was kind of keeping my distance. Now, I've actually done it to where I fought all three before, but I've never done it with a mage. So I have never tried to actually physically kill three at a time with a mage. I don't think it's realistic to, well, actually anything in this game is realistic to try. There is no, like, perfect strategy or anything as such. And I always forget. But there's, like, actually, there's more hidden doors. I know it. Because there's one... Hold on. Is it right here? I'm, like, just walking against the walls and pressing X because I know. Yes! It's like, you think that, you know, you think you found the secret, and then you're like, aw. And then you find out there's another secret, and it's like, oh, that's cool. And then you don't expect there to be four secrets. What? Well, although this one, I don't think actually... Well, that's all right. I don't think that actually had anything in there. I think there's even another. But maybe I'm wrong. Well, anyway, so we can go through the door and move forward. That can be a thing, but you know what happens? Something happens when you walk through the door to the area that you're going to go to, and you don't expect it. It kills me. It kills me that you don't. The game... Oh, wait. So which way is the right way to go now? I don't remember now. We came in... Which way? Was this the way we came in? Door ahead. Uh-huh. Okay. I'm getting disoriented. Oh, no, we came in from up there. So anything that doesn't look like these little doorway, hallway things is actually, I guess, the right way. So it was this way. But this right here kills me. Because you can die so easily at this point in the game. I forget what it is. It's like a trap or something. I don't think it's the exploding enemies, but I hear them. So maybe I'm wrong. Man, my frame rate just increased a lot. Okay. It's not here. Okay. No. I remember. We can jump and get that. I don't want to risk it right now. I want to make sure that I'm staying aware of my surroundings. Touch the bloodstains. Let's watch. All right, so he goes there. Yep. Yep. Something. Some kind of a... Yeah, it's that guy. Oh my gosh. So, what do you have? You have enemies that blow up and just kill you. Well, that's not very fair, especially since you're right in front of a bonfire. And this is actually where I'm going to end this episode, actually. Because we did a thing. We very much did a thing, actually. And I'm excited. So look, I want to thank you for joining intplusone Channel's Let's Play Dark Souls 2 Scholar of the First Sin. Episode 7. And I'm about to start recording episode 8 momentarily. In just a moment. In just a second moment. So, come back. Watch this. This is a great game, and I hope you enjoy it. What I want you to do, though, and cue the outro, okay? I want you to, in the following order, I want you to like this video. And if you haven't subscribed, I want you to subscribe. And if you haven't ever commented, comment on this video. I'm going to say that with every video, though, so it doesn't matter. But comment on this video. Give me some feedback. Tell me what I'm doing right. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. My goal here is to entertain. My goal here is to show you this amazing game. And I just want to make sure that this is, you know, as cool of an experience for me as it is for you. And, you know, you can give me your advice. I'll ignore it, and it'll be great. So do that. Do the thing. Join me next time. Bermelengi.